Hi kids, in today's session you are going to learn about marine resources. Under that you are going to learn about the conservation of it also. First we will know about the marine resources. The biotic and abiotic resources found in the oceanic water and at the bottoms are called as a marine resources. The ocean resources play an important role in sustaining the needs of the society. A diverse array of marine organisms used for food, medicine, cosmetics, and also a wealth of industrial applications. The world's demand for energy, minerals, and water have become increasingly dependent on non-living marine resources. Actually, marine resources, what are the marine resources we are getting, you know? Energy, mineral, and biological resources. Energy resources like fuels, tidal energy, wave energy like that. Mineral resources like petroleum, natural gas, metallic minerals, sand, gravel, so many things we are getting from as a mineral resources from the marine. And the biological resources, fishes, plankton, seagrass, coral, so many things we are getting from marine alone. Next, conservation of marine resources. The humankind depends on the marine resources, isn't it, for survival purpose. They are also essential for the economic prosperity, social well-being, and quality of life. Oceans have extensive deposits of oil reserves. Besides a major fishing ground, it helps in generating non-conventional energy, development of many ports and harbors for trade activities too. Okay, coastal tourism also attracts people around the world, thereby contributing to the economy of many countries. So definitely we should conserve our marine resources. Okay, oceans, it is the blood of planet, earth planet, and also for the mankind. Next we will know about the Great Barrier Reef. The Great Barrier Reef is the world's largest coral reef system, composed of 2,900 individual reefs and 900 islands stretching for about 2,000 kilometers. It covers an area of about 350,000 kilometers. The reef is located in the Coral Sea off the coast of Queensland, Australia. The Great Barrier Reef can be seen from the outer space. This sprawling coral reef system is one of the most biologically diverse places on the planet. Coral reefs are built by billions of tiny organisms which are known as the coral polyps. CNN labeled it as one of the seven natural wonders of the world. The gangetic dolphin was declared as the national aquatic animal in 2010, which became an endangered species. Major ocean currents and effects. South Atlantic Ocean. In that ocean, Benguela Current is a cold current. It leads to foggy conditions along the coast of Namibia, helped in the development of Namibian and Kalahari deserts. North Atlantic Ocean. In that, Canaries and Labrador are called as the cold current. Gulf Stream and North Atlantic Drift is a warm current. Influences the extension of Sahara Desert. Canaries cold current is influence the extension of the Sahara Desert. Gulf Stream warm current, its confluence with the Labrador current, which produces heavy fog along the coast of Newfoundland, which is known as the fishing ground of the world. North Atlantic Drift warm current, it keeps the ports at higher latitudes ice free throughout the year. Okay, next, Labrador cold current, its confluence with Gulf Stream creates fog and hinders navigations. Okay, next, South Pacific Ocean. Peruvian cold current, helped in the desertification of the Atacama Desert, El Nino affects the weather in Western and South America. It also affects timely arrival of Indian monsoon. In this, Crucio current is the warm current. It plays a vital role in carrying large amount of heat to the adjacent land areas and forms cloud cover that causes rainfall. North Pacific Ocean. In that only I said about the Crucio current, okay. And Kuruli current, its confluence with the Crucio current produces heavy fogs around Hokkaido, which become potential hazards for navigation. Alaska warm current, which keeps the seaports of Alaska open throughout the year. California cold current leads to foggy conditions along the coast of California, and it helped in the development of Arizona and Sonora desert. In Indian Ocean, West Australian cold current leads to foggy conditions along the western coast of Australia, which helped in the genesis of West Australian desert.